it's not much of a surprise that in entering into another new season, Alexander Ovechkin is once again among the top goal scorers in the NHL. Ovechkin is always at or near the top of the goal leaderboards, and has won the Rocket Richard Trophy as the league's top goal scorer a record 9 times. What might be a surprise is that Ovechkin is also among the league leaders in assists, a skill that isn't usually attributed to his game, and is second in the league in points at the moment, ahead of Connor McDavid. Ovechkin is on a pace to break career records in goals, assists, and points 20-odd games into his 17th NHL season, so I think the question is fair to ask. Is this Ovechkin's prime? Is Alexander Ovechkin playing the best hockey of his career in his 17th season at 36 years old? In looking at Alexander Ovechkin's career numbers for an earlier video, I was surprised to see that Ovechkin has only broken the 60-goal plateau once in his career, with 65 goals in his third season in 2007-2008. The key to Ovechkin's high goal-scoring numbers for his career has been consistency. Aside from the shortened season in 2020 and this active season, Ovechkin has never scored less than 30 goals in a season in his entire 17 years in the NHL. As previously mentioned, he's scored 60 or more goals once, but additionally has scored 50 or more goals 8 times and 40 or more goals 10 times. In terms of overall point production, Ovechkin peaked in the first 5 years of his career. In his rookie season, he put up 106 points. Following that, 92 points in 06-07, his career high 112 points along with 65 goals in 07-08, and then 110 and 109 points in the following 2 seasons. After those initial 5 seasons, while Ovechkin was still putting up superstar numbers throughout the years, the point production was noticeably lower. However, while his career high in goals was 65 in 82 games, in 2008 for a fitting 0.8 goals per game average, Ovechkin currently has 19 goals in 22 games, which in the moment is his best goals per game pace ever, with 0.86 goals per game. Additionally, his points per game pace is higher than ever. In his career-high season of 112 points, Ovechkin had a 1.37 points per game average. He actually outpaced that in his 109-point season, as he missed 9 games, with 1.51 points per game. However, through his first 22 games this season, Ovechkin's points per game is 1.68. You may be thinking, okay, so he's got a better pace than he's had before, he's also only played 22 games so far, and that's a completely fair point. Ovechkin has a long way to go continuing at such extraordinary scoring paces before he eclipses the career totals that he's previously established. The thing is, this is already not the same as any other previous OV season or start. Through his first 20 games, Alexander Ovechkin broke the Capitals franchise record for most points through 20 games. After 3 assists in game number 20 of the season, Ovechkin had 33 points through his first 20. This has been the best pace of his career, and Ovi's shown no signs of slowing down. If you're not yet convinced, consider the roster that Ovi is working with. The Capitals have always been good, and they still are. At the moment of this recording, the Capitals sit at the top of the league, tied with Toronto on points. More than ever, though, the reason the Capitals are at the top of the league is because of Ovi. After 10 games, Anthony Mantha went down with a shoulder injury, and is expected to be out until January. T.J. Oshie, one of the Capitals' top scorers over the past few seasons, is expected to come back to the lineup soon, but has only played 8 games this season after sustaining a lower body injury. And most notably, Nicklas Backstrom, the first-line playmaking star who's been paired with Ovechkin for the wide majority of most of their careers, has missed the entire season so far with a hip injury. Ovechkin has been producing at the best rate of his career to this point, without 2 key point-producing wingers that could certainly help create space for Ovi on the power play, and his key line mate who has played almost the entirety of his career by his side. While these injuries likely impact Ovechkin's ability to score even more points, it's worth noting that many other players have stepped up in their absence. Evgeny Kuznetsov is having one of the best years of his career playing a larger role in Backstrom's absence, with 27 points through his first 22 games. Tom Wilson is producing at a point-per-game pace in what looks like is going to be a career-high year. And John Carlson is scoring as he always does, with 22 points in 22 games from the blue line. There's a reason the Capitals are still at the top of the league, even with their injuries. But missing the star talent that the Capitals are missing certainly doesn't make things any easier for Ovechkin. There's many more things you can consider when discussing the best a player has ever played in his career. Some may say that Ovechkin peaked when he led the Capitals to the Stanley Cup in 2018, as he had to captain the team through tough games en route to winning the Cup and the Conn Smythe as the best player in the 2018 playoffs. Some may say that Ovechkin peaked when he was younger, was making dynamic plays nearly every game and laying out devastating hits while flying across the ice. But if you choose to judge a player's ability by the goals they score and the goals they create, Ovechkin is having the best season of his career. For whatever elements he may have lost or regressed in over the years, he seems to have added even more in return. When it comes to purely points and goals, Alexander Ovechkin is in the prime of his career in NHL season 17 at the age of 36.